Welcome all of you to the 12th online lectures. Today we are going to start with the new topic, that is national income. As we know that there are two branches of economics, as we have learned in the 11th. First one is microeconomics and second one is macroeconomics. We know that in microeconomics we study about the individual units, but as in the macroeconomics we study about the aggregate of units. Means we can say that we study about the total economy as a whole. So when we discuss this national income, it is a part of the macroeconomics. That is why it is called as national income is an important subject matter of macroeconomics. There are a number of firms, number of factories, shops, and all the things we can say that there are number of businesses available in the country. Then how to calculate the income of that particular businesses or the particular country? It is the part that studies the national income. That is why this national income is an important subject matter of macroeconomics. Then national income is a composite measure of all economic activities. What is mean by composite measure? We take all the economic activities in a composite manner, in a particular manner. That is why it is called as a composite measure of all economic activities. Which are those economic activities? Production, distribution, exchange, and consumption. When we take all these activities together and calculate the income of a particular country, that is why it is called as the national income. There are two particular agencies. In 1949, the government of India established National Income Committee. That committee was appointed with this task of measurement of national income. Then in the today's scenario, there is one office that is known as Central Statistical Office. That Central Statistical Office is the office which measures the national income of the country. This is an introductory part. We know that there are various types of income, individual income, then personal income, then we can say that national income. When we look at the income at the individual level, that is called as personal income. But when we look at the income at the national level, when we take all the activities happening in the country, whether it is production, whether it is distribution, whether it is exchange or consumption, when we take all these activities together and calculate the income of the country, it becomes the national income. That is why in this part we are going to study about the total economy and how the income is calculated in this total economy. First of all, we come to the meaning of national income. In simple language, we measure the income in terms of money. Why it is so? Because the income cannot be measured in terms of goods and services. Hum jo hamari national income hai usko goods and services ke taur pe nahi dekh sakte. Kitne mobile humne produce kiye, kitne benches humne produce kiye, kitne classes humne produce kiye, in sab ko agar hum ek register mein maintain karne jayenge to wahan pe hame problem hoga. That is why we take the aggregate value of that particular commodities, and that value is counted in terms of money. And today's economy, the modern economy, hamari jo abhi ki economy hai, wo money economy hai. That is why the national income is measured in terms of money. Then total income of the nation is called as national income. In simple language, if we want to define the national income, total income of the nation is called as national income. Or there is one specific definition of the GDP, the money value of all final goods and services produced in the country during one year is called as national income. Then in real terms, national income is the flow of goods and services produced in economy during a year. Whatever the goods and services, there are n number of industries, there are n number of factories, there are n number of, we can say that, companies available, there are n number of departments available. By taking all these departments, all these companies together, whatever the goods and services are produced by that particular things is called as the national income. So in real terms, national income is called as the flow of goods and services. Whatever the goods and services produced in the economy during one year, that will be called as national income. Agar hum national income ko define karna chahenge to simple language mein usko is tarah se define kiya ja sakta hai, jo hamare territorial boundaries hain, उस टेरिटोरियल बाउंड्रीज में जो हमारे सारे बिजनेसमैन हैं, सारे हमारे यूनिट्स हैं, उन सारे यूनिट्स ने जितने भी मिलके गुड्स एंड सर्विसेज का प्रोडक्शन किया है, दैट विल बी कॉल्ड एज द नेशनल इनकम. देन डेफिनेशंस ऑफ नेशनल इनकम इन द बुक, देर आर थ्री डेफिनेशंस गिवन. फर्स्ट डेफिनेशन इज बाय नेशनल इनकम कमिटी. इन दैट कमिटी देर वेर थ्री पर्सन्स. फर्स्ट वन इज प्रोफेसर पी सी महालनोबिस, सेकेंड वन इज डॉक्टर गाडगिल, देन वी के आर वी राव. PC Mahalanobis was the chairman and other two members are the two are the members. According to National Income Committee, what is national income? A national estimate measures the volume of commodities and services turned out during a period counted without duplication. There are 3 points to remember here. First one, national estimate. National estimates mean national income in simple language. Then measure the volume of commodities and services. As we have already discussed, what is national income? It is the volume of goods and services produced in the country. Turned out. What is the meaning of this turned out? The meaning of this turned out is simple production. Okay, whatever the goods and services produced in the country during 1 year counted without duplication. Now this is a very important point. Counted without duplication, what does this mean? Suppose हमने एक मोबाइल प्रोड्यूस किया, जब हम वो मोबाइल प्रोड्यूस करेंगे तो एक कंपनी में वो मोबाइल कभी भी प्रोड्यूस नहीं होता है. Why it is so? Because there are multiple things, or we can say that multiple raw material is required for producing the mobile, and that raw material is produced in different factories, and for that different factories that particular output will be the final product. But when we take the value of the mobile, there will be double counting. That is why, to avoid that double counting, what is important is that there must be the reduction in the value, or we can say that the value must not be counted again and again. For example, we take the bike. When we produce one bike, for example Hero Honda bike, when that Hero Honda company produces that bike, he purchases various parts from other companies. For example, we can take the tire. The tire is purchased from, suppose, TVS or Seat. Then we take the headlamps, it can be produced for purchased from the Lumax. There are lots of companies. But when we take the value of that particular bike, it happens that it is the final product of that particular company, and it will be called in the national income. But when we take the value of tire, that tire is counted twice. Once in that particular TVS factory, and second time in the particular bike company. So there will be double counting, or we can say that inflation of the national income. That is why, to avoid that inflation, to avoid that increase in the value, what is important is that the calculation of the national income must be without duplication. Then we come to the second definition. It is given by A.C. Pigou. According to him, national dividend is that part of objective income of the community, including, of course, income derived from abroad, which can be measured in money. Again, we come to the point, measured in money. National income can be measured in the money. What the Pigou says is that it is a part of objective income of the community. Now, we are not talking about the single person. We are talking about the community. We are talking about the nation. That is why national income will be called as the income of the nation, income of the community in total. Then, including, of course, income derived from abroad. Okay, whatever the income is derived from the abroad, it will be also considered in the national income. Then we come to the third definition. It is given by Professor Irving Fisher. According to him, national dividend or income consists solely of services as received by ultimate customers, whether from their material or from their human environments. Now, this Fisher is talking about the services received by the consumers. Whatever the services received by the consumers, all these things will be counted in the national income. There are again multiple definitions of the national income. We just need to discuss these three. Then we come to the most important point, features of national income. What are the features of national income? First feature is that it is a macroeconomic concept. We know that there are two types of economics available, microeconomics and macroeconomics. In 1933, the economics is divided into two parts. Then what this concept, national income concept, depends, or we can say that regards to the macroeconomics. Why it is so? Because in national income, we study about all the people or all the economic activities happening in the country. That is why it is considered as the macroeconomic concept. When we study about only one individual, it will be called as the microeconomic concept. But when we study about the total nation or the all the people in the country, that will be called as the macroeconomic concept. And in national income, we study about total nation. That is why it is called as macroeconomic concept. Then second one is value of final goods and services only. Now we will take one example here. What is mean by value of final goods and services? For example, to avoid double counting, as we have discussed in one definition, to avoid double counting. How the double counting happens? Let us take one example. For example, suppose we are taking one bike. That bike we will call as Hero Honda bike. Suppose that bike cost us ₹50,000. How much? It is cost as 50,000. In that 50,000 value, the value of all the products are included, means the value of bike is included. But when we take the output of the TVS company which produces tires, TVS company is another one company which produces the tires, okay, and when suppose the tires are of ₹5,000, okay, then what happens here is that this same tire is used for producing this particular bike. Okay, here will be double counting. Why it is so? Because this tire is already counted as the final product of the TVS company, and then when we make one bike, what is happening here is that the value of this tire is again counted in the value of bike. So here will be double counting. So what is important here is that value of final goods and services only. If we take the value of the bike, we should not take the value of the tire as separately. That is called as value of final goods and services, because sometimes what happens is that intermediate goods or raw materials are taken as the values, but there will be double counting. And to avoid that double counting, what is important here is that we take the value of only final goods and services. Then we can take another one example. For example, while we take the value of the shirts, what will happen? We can take the value of the cotton also. That cotton is already a final product of another industry. That is why there is double counting in the economy. So what is important here is that to avoid the double counting, the value of only final goods and services needs to be taken in the economy. Then next point is net aggregate value. What is mean by net aggregate value is that net aggregate value of goods and services produced and does not include depreciation. There is one formula used here. What is mean by net aggregate value is that in the net aggregate value, we take total value and we reduce the depreciation. Why the depreciation is reduced? Because the goods are already produced in some previous year and the value of that particular goods is reduced from the national income. So to get accurate measure of national income, what is important here is that we take the net aggregate value. Then we come to the next point, net income earned from abroad. Okay, what is mean by abroad? From another country, we can say that there are two types of income earned from abroad. We can take export and import. Export means the goods produced in our country will be exported to our other country, and the goods produced in the other country will be imported to our country. The net value of that particular thing needs to be taken in the national income. Then receipts and payments. There are some businessmen which works in the multiple countries. We can say that multinational corporations. Some companies earns profit in our country and some companies earns profits in the other country. So what is important here is that when we take the value of the goods and services, we need to take the net income earned from abroad. Hamare jo businessmen hai jinhone kahin kisi aur country mein jaake wahan pe apna production kiya hoga aur wahan se income kamai hogi, wo income hamare national income mein add hogi. Aur jo foreign businessmen hai जिन्होंने हमारे कंट्री में इनकम कमाई है, वो इनकम क्या होगी? हमारे जो नेशनल इनकम है उससे रिड्यूस होगी, एंड दैट वैल्यू विल बी कॉल्ड एज द नेट इनकम अर्न फ्रॉम एब्रॉड. नेक्स्ट वन, फिनेंशियल ईयर. एज द स्टूडेंट ऑफ कॉमर्स वी नो दैट फिनेंशियल ईयर स्टार्ट फ्रॉम 1st April एंड एंड्स ऑन 31st March. सो वेन वी टेक द वैल्यू ऑफ नेशनल इनकम, वॉट एवर द गुड्स एंड सर्विसेज प्रोड्यूस ड्यूरिंग दैट वन ईयर, only those values or those goods and services will be taken in the national income. Then flow concept. It shows flow of goods and services produced in the economy during a year. Whatever the goods and services produced in the economy in one year, that will be called as the flow of goods and services, and only that flow is considered. The goods produced in the last year will not be taken. The goods to be produced in the next year will not be taken. We will take only the goods produced in that particular one year. Then next one, money value. As we know that we cannot count any commodity in numbers. We cannot say that we have produced 1,000 of planes. We cannot say that we have produced 1 million mobiles. It is not possible. So to take the value of the particular commodity, what is important is that we take the value in terms of money. That is why it is called as the money value. It is called as the money value. These are the features of national income. First one is macroeconomic concept. Second one is value of final goods and services. Third one is net aggregate value. Then net national income from abroad. Then financial year flow concept and the money value. Then we move to the next point, that is circular flow of national income. It is very important point in the macroeconomics and it is a very basic point in the macroeconomics. What is mean by circular flow? Circular flow means we will take one circle. Suppose this is a circle and this circle goes on continuously. And in the same manner, our national income also goes on revolving continuously in a circular manner from one person to another, from another to another, and then that comes to that particular final person. That is why it is called as the circular flow of national income. Now we come to the definition. What is mean by circular flow of national income? It refers to a process by which an economy's receipts and payments, it flows in a circular manner continuously through times. जो भी हमारे receipts और payments होंगे वो क्या करेंगे, जो time है हमारा उस time में circular flow करेंगे. That is why it is called as the circular flow of national income. There are three types of economy: two sector economy, three sector economy, and third one is four sector economy. In two sector economy, only two sectors are considered. First one is household and second one is firms. Then in the three sector economy, three sectors are considered: household, business firms and the government sector. And in the four sector economy, household, business firm, government and the foreign sector, these are the four sectors considered in the particular economy. So here are some formulas. In the two sector economy, income is equal to C plus I. Okay, Y is equal to C plus I. Y means income, C means consumption of the household or the household consumption expenditure, I means business firms, the investment made by the business firm. These three things will be considered in the two sector economy. Then we come to the three sector economy. Y is equal to C plus I plus G. Now here one thing is added, that is G. Okay, what is that G? It will be called as the government sector. Then we come to the four sector economy. Y is equal to C plus I plus G plus X minus M. Here X minus M is added. What is that X minus M? Net export, we can say that, or net income from abroad, export minus import. Then there is only one point to discuss, that is two sector economy. How? In the two sector economy, the national income flows circularly. That is the thing we are going to discuss. So here is one chart given, and in that chart how the national income circulates in the two sector economy is given. Two sectors are given here. First one is household and second one is firms. Okay, we know that there are four factors of production. Which are those? Land, labor, capital and entrepreneur. And the household means we can say that the people are the owner of these four factors of production. Okay, these four factors of production will be provided by the household to the firms. See the outer circle. That outer circle will shows us the flow of factors, and the inner circle shows us the flow of income, we can say that. Okay, so for example, suppose from household, land, labor, capital and entrepreneur, these are the four factors given to the business firm. Then that business firm, what will do that business firm? It will utilize all these four factors of production and it will produce the goods and services. Then these goods and services will flow from the business firm to the household. In this way, the first circle continues and it goes on continuously. That is why it is called as the circular flow of national income. And that particular circle, first circle, is called as the This first circle is called as, we can say that, a product flow.
Okay, first circle is called as the
product flow, or we can say that the factor flow, land, labor, capital and entrepreneur. Then we come to the second circle. In that second circle, what happens? The goods and services are already given to the household. Then the household will give the value of those goods and services to the business sector or the firms. Okay, for the consumption expenditure, we can say that whatever we want to purchase, whatever we want to buy, we have to give the value to that particular person, to that particular firm. So when we purchase the goods and services, what happens is that we give the value to the firms, means the money flows to the firms, and that money is again given by the firms to the household in the manner of factor income. What is meant by factor income? The household has provided land, labor, capital and entrepreneur, and it is not provided freely. So what will happen? The firm have to provide some income to the household, and that income is provided in four things: rent, wages, interest and profit. Rent is given to the land, then wages are given to the labor, then capital is given, interest is given to the capital, and profit is given to the enterprise services provided by that particular household. And in this manner, this circle goes on continuously. That is why it is called as the circular flow of national income. That particular inner circle is called as the money flow, because the money flows from household to firms and from firms to household. इसमें होता क्या है, जो हमारे हाउसहोल्ड होते हैं, मतलब जो हमारे पीपल होते हैं, वो क्या करते हैं, उनके पास फोर फैक्टर्स ऑफ प्रोडक्शन अवेलेबल है. वी हैव डिस्कस्ड इन द 11th लेक्चर व्हिच आर दोस फोर फैक्टर्स ऑफ प्रोडक्शन. लेट्स रिमाइंड, लैंड, लेबर, कैपिटल एंड एंटरप्रेन्योर. मीन्स ये जो फोर फैक्टर्स ऑफ प्रोडक्शन होंगे, वो क्या करेंगे, जो हाउस होल्ड है उनसे किसको जाएंगे, बिजनेस फर्म्स को जाएंगे. बिजनेस फर्म क्या करेंगे, उन जो फोर फैक्टर्स ऑफ प्रोडक्शन है उसका इस्तेमाल करके गुड्स एंड सर्विसेज प्रोड्यूस करेंगे. जब वो गुड्स एंड सर्विसेज प्रोड्यूस होगी तो क्या होगा, वो गुड्स एंड सर्विसेज अगेन किसको जाएगा, हाउसहोल्ड को जाएगा. सी इन दिस आउटर सर्कल, दैट आउटर सर्कल इज कॉल्ड एज द फ्लो ऑफ प्रोडक्ट्स, प्रोडक्ट फ्लो इट इज कॉल्ड एज. देन वी कम टू द इनर सर्कल, जो हमारा इनर सर्कल दिख रहा है, इसमें क्या होगा, जब हमने कोई कमोडिटीज परचेस कर ली, जब हमने कोई गुड्स एंड सर्विसेज प्रोड्यूस कर ली, हम क्या करेंगे, जो मनी है वो मनी किसको देंगे, फर्म्स को देंगे. ओके, सो कंजम्पशन एक्सपेंडिचर ऑन गुड्स एंड सर्विसेज गोज टू द फर्म्स, मतलब जो हमारी जेब में पैसा है वो किसको जाएगा, फर्म्स को जाएगा. फर्म क्या करेगी इस पैसे का, जो हमारे लैंड और लेबर कैपिटल एंटरप्रेन्योर है उसको परचेस करने के लिए उसका कुछ ना कुछ रिवॉर्ड देना पड़ेगा. क्या रिवॉर्ड होगा, वो लैंड के लिए दिया जाएगा रेंट, लेबर के लिए दिया जाएगा वेजेस, देन कैपिटल के लिए दिया जाएगा इंटरेस्ट, एंड एंटरप्रेन्योरल सर्विसेज के लिए दिया जाएगा प्रॉफिट. इन दिस वे दिस सर्कल गोज ऑन कंटिन्यूअसली, देर इज नो ब्रेक इन दिस सर्कल व्हेन वी टेक द टू सेक्टर इकोनॉमी. दैट इज व्हाई इट इज कॉल्ड एज सर्क्यूलर फ्लो ऑफ नेशनल इनकम. So what we have studied, let's remind. Firstly, we have discussed the meaning of national income. Then what is national income? It is an important factor of subject matter of macroeconomics. Then all the services and goods produced in the economy is called as the national income. All these things we have discussed. Then we have discussed the definition of national economy, national income. There are three definitions given by National Income Committee, then AC Pigou and the Irving Fisher. Then the features of national income, there are in total 7 features we have discussed. It is a macroeconomic concept. Then value of final goods and services will be taken in the national income. Then net aggregate value, then net income from abroad, then financial year flow concept and money value, all these things we have discussed. Circular flow of national income, just remind this circle, you can draw this circle on your page also. So here our first lecture ends, and in the next lecture we will start with the next point. Thank you.